Hey, Jewel City Church family and all of our friends that join us. Here we are. It's Thursday. A lot of you are close to a weekend and looks like the weather's going to be nice. And I just want to share a little bit of the Word of God with you. When we think about persecution as Christians, we think about back in biblical times, but persecution has always been amongst the born-again believers, not only in other countries, but right here in America. Persecution is real. It seems to me like we're living in a time that if we don't agree with other people, people lash out and they persecute us as believers in Christ. The old flesh wants to rise up and come back right at an individual, but that's not the Word of God. And that's what I want to share with us today, because I really believe persecution is at a high right now in America. I believe the body of Christ is under attack, and we know that our battles are not with flesh and blood. We know it's with the enemy. So how do we fight our battles? We sing a song here. This is how I fight my battles, in prayer and praise and worship. But also it's by the Word of God and knowing the Word of God. And I find this so powerful. Listen to Romans 12 and 14. Bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not. So friend, we've got to find a way to be a blessing to people. I didn't say we had to be a doormat. I didn't say we had to allow people to just plow over top of us, but I do believe there's a way in handling everything. And to the best of our ability, we need to be peacemakers, and we need to pray for those and to love those. Listen to 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 12 and 13. This is so powerful. When we are cursed, we bless. When we are persecuted, we endure it. When we are slandered, we answer kindly. Friend, a good friend of mine, I always put my hand on his heart and I tell him, keep your heart soft. Persecution can harden our heart, and we can just come right back at people in a way that is not pleasing to God. So let's try to be kind, gentle, meek, humble, forgiving. Let's be loving, even when we're persecuted. Now again, I didn't say stand there and let someone beat on you all day. All right, we got to protect ourselves physically. But friend, let's take the high road, because God will honor that. I pray that encourages you today. Pray for America, that we'll become one, unified, that they would be a great move of God in America. Before we close today, how about your heart? Is your heart right with God? I remember now, I think it's been 38 years ago that I gave my life to Christ. I was in an old-fashioned revival, and a pastor said these words, if you was to die today, would heaven be your home? He didn't have to say anything else. I was on the back row. I got up before an invitation was ever given. I tell people I took the best 12-step program I could ever take. I took about 12 steps to an altar. I knelt down and began to weep and began to pray. The Spirit of God touched my heart, changed my life, changed my thoughts, changed my eternal destiny. We want your eternal destiny to be heaven. Do you know God? If death was to knock at your door today, would heaven be your home? Friend, if you can't answer that, absolutely yes. Most people say, I hope so. That is not good. You need to have a no-so. If you feel the Spirit of the Lord speaking to your heart and you know that you're not right with God, pray this prayer, Lord Jesus, I know that I'm not ready for eternity. Today, I ask you to forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me change my heart, change my mind. Lord, from this day forward, I'll do my best to live my life for you. Wow. If you prayed that prayer, give me a call at 304-669-1140 or shoot me a text. I'd love to be able to give you a call and pray with you. Friend, it's very important. The Bible said, forsake not the assembling of ourselves together in the house of the Lord. Even greater so, as you see that day approaching, you need a church. You need a church family. We need each other. So I want you to pray and ask God to lead you to a church that will help you, love you, and grow you. Friend, you are most definitely welcome here at Jewel City. We meet on Sunday mornings at 9 o'clock. Again, on Sunday mornings at 11 o'clock. The 11 o'clock hour has nursery, kids' church. We want you to come and check it out. Every Sunday evening at 6 o'clock, we have something for all ages, clear through college. God bless and have a beautiful weekend.
For additional Christ-centered content, make sure to follow us on Facebook and Instagram, subscribe on YouTube, and check out the Jewel City Podcast.